The new official face of American poetry is one familiar to NewsHour viewers. Natasha Trethewey has just taken on the job of Poet Laureate of the United States, appointed by the Librarian of Congress. She's author of 4 books of verse, including the Pulitzer Prize-winning Native Guard and her latest, Thrall. Trethewey is 46. She's a professor of English at Emory University and also currently serves as laureate for the state of Mississippi, where she was born. Welcome back and congratulations.
Thank you.
The laureate post sometimes is given to an older, well-established sort of star of this poetry world. You're younger, mid-career, still out and about, growing.
That's right.
You're aware of, is it a different energy? Is it a different sense of that you're bringing to this?
Well, I'm hoping that my youth, relatively speaking, means I'm also energetic and can bring a lot of service to the role rather than simply ceremonial or honorific, as it is certainly is.
Mm-hmm. How do you see the role, I guess? It's an interesting question, right?
Well, you know, you're a cheerleader for poetry, a promoter.
A cheerleader.
That's right. but the role really is to try to bring poetry to as wide an audience as possible. And so it's my job to think of as many ways possible to do that.
And how have you thought about that? I saw that your one thing you're planning to do is actually sort of be in residence.
That's right.
Here in Washington and at the Library of Congress.
That is the first thing. I'll be the first one to have done that in a very long time. And so I'm hoping that in that capacity, I'll be able to have regular office hours, invite people to the Poetry Center to talk with me about poetry and what's important about it in our lives in that office.
You know, there's the proverbial, what is the role of poetry in our culture anyway?
Mm-hmm.
It's always interesting to me. Here we are in the middle of a political campaign. You hear a lot of one kind of rhetoric.
Mm-hmm.
Poetry is a different kind of language, right?
That's right. That's right. Poetry I said this the other day, I think it's way more diplomatic than we ever are in our everyday lives.
More diplomatic?
That's right.
What does that mean?
Because it can speak to all of us. It helps us not only to grieve our losses, but to celebrate our joys and triumphs. It is open to all of us. It's the best thing we've got. It's the most humane repository for our feelings and our thoughts, our most humane and dignified thoughts.
Your new book, you have it there, it picks up on some themes that we've talked about before here.
Yes.
I know your interests in history, in family, your own family's experience, race.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about the new book.
Well, the new book started with an investigation of Mexican Costa paintings. I was very interested in these because they represented the mixed blood unions that were taking place in the colony across the 18th century. I was, of course, drawn to them because they had the picture of the parents as well as the offspring and the taxonomies, the names created for those mixed blood children. So it was like looking at portraits of my own family.
Well, explain that to people. That is your own history.
That's right.
What was it? As I recall, an illegal marriage at the time.
That's right. My parents had to go to Ohio to get married in 1965 because it was still illegal in Mississippi. My white father and black mother.
Mm-hmm. So when you look at, what is it that you want to look at through the poems when you want to explore that history?
Well, I'm trying to make sense of my own contemporary experience across time and space, to make sense of myself through the lens of history.
Mm-hmm.
These things are not new to us. They've been going on for a long time, and people have been thinking about them for a long time. And my experience now is reflected through that larger public history.
Is there a poem you could read for us?
Yes. I'd like to read a poem that's a slightly different take on the elegy, because my father is still alive. Elegy for my father. I think by now the river must be thick with salmon. Late August, I imagine it as it was that morning, drizzle needling the surface, mist at the banks like a net settling around us, everything damp and shining. That morning, awkward and heavy in our hip waders, we stalked into the current and found our places, you upstream a few yards and out far deeper. You must remember how the river seeped in over your boots and you grew heavier with that defeat. All day I kept turning to watch you, how first you mimed our guide's casting, then cast your invisible line, slicing the sky between us. and later, rod in hand, how you tried again and again to find that perfect arc, flight of an insect skimming the river's surface. Perhaps you recall I cast my line and reeled in two small trout we could not keep. Because I had to release them, I confess, I thought about the past, working the hooks loose, the fish writhing in my hands, each one slipping away before I could let go. I can tell you now that I tried to take it all in, record it for an elegy I'd write one day when the time came. Your daughter, I was that ruthless. What does it matter if I tell you I learned to be? You kept casting your line, and when it did not come back empty, it was tangled with mine. Some nights, dreaming, I step again into the small boat that carried us out and watch the bank receding, my back to where I know we are headed.
An elegy for your father, even though he's still alive. What made you want to do that?
Well, the poem actually elegizes something else, not the loss of the person, but a loss of a certain kind of relationship with the person. So he's still here, but some part of our relationship as father and daughter has changed. It's different now, the older I get, the older he gets.
For those who, you know, don't get poetry, mm-hmm. or you know, feel disconnected from it, mm-hmm. do you think of them when you're writing? And of course, now you're taking on a very public role as the Laureate.
Mm-hmm. I do think of them when I'm writing, because even though I'm the daughter of a poet, I think I felt like that myself at some point.
You felt disconnected?
Yes, I think I felt at some point that I couldn't understand poetry, or that it was beyond me, or it didn't speak to my experience. And I think that was because I hadn't yet found the right poems to invite me in. I think there's a poem out there for everyone to be an entrance into poetry and a relationship with it.
Well, so what was it for you? That'll help people. Who did you read, or who do you read?
You know,
what are the models?
I was going to say, when my mother died, the poem that made sense to me and invited me into poetry was Auden's Musée des Beaux-Arts that begins about suffering. They were never wrong, the old masters. And, you know, it's a poem that goes on to describe how, you know, this tiny little image of Icarus falling into the sea while everything else is going on around the world. That's what grief sometimes feels like, that you're the only person experiencing it and the whole world is going on about its business without you. That actually comforted me in my loss.
That's a very personal take on things. Are you excited now about the public role that you're taking on?
I think so. I'm very excited.
You think so?
I think I am.
I'm a little,
well,
convinced.
You know, it's a big responsibility, yeah. And I want to do it well. And so that means that I am a little anxious about it. And so it means I'm also going to try very hard to find the best ways to do it.
All right. Natasha Trethewey is the new Poet Laureate of the United States. Your new book is Thrall. Nice to talk to you.
Nice talking with you, Jeff.